behind all music, there are scientific principles of sound. Through the use of homemade instruments, I demonstrate these scientific principles to encourage musical curiosity in children. I want them to realize that there are no limits to creative expression. Now, theremin is the only instrument in the world that you can actually play without touching it. And the way that works is that this antenna over here is at this moment sending out radio waves to all of us. And by blocking those radio waves with your hand, you can control the sound that it makes. This crossing over between science and music works both ways, as one can also use music to encourage curiosity in science. These days, with modern technology, you can also alter sound with the help of electronic effects. So I'll now show you how that works with the help of my good friends, High Octave and Low Octave. Give me 1 minute, I'll bring them out for you.
Hello there, my name is High Octave. How you guys doing?
Hello there, my name is Low Octave. Hey, are you guys laughing at me? Are you laughing at me?
Hey guys, chill out. Don't laugh at the big guy. You don't want to make him angry.
Yeah, you don't want to make me angry.
When I was traveling in Africa 10 years ago, I was amazed to see folks your age making musical instruments out of recycled items such as tin cans that were lying around. You see, they understood the wisdom of not allowing things to go to waste. So rather than simply throwing these things away, they were transforming them into beautiful musical instruments. Now watch as before your eyes, I transform this wooden spoon into a musical instrument. First, I need a piece of string. In this case, I'm using a piece of rubber tubing. Next, I need a bridge. So a bridge is basically a small piece of wood that's going to focus the vibrations from this string onto the body of the spoon and translate it into sound. Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the singing spoon!
Future scientists need solutions for growing waste. Critical thinking reveals alternatives to throwing away used items.
All sound comes from vibrations. And what's happening here is that the metal is vibrating in a sound chamber, which in this case is your mouth. And by changing the shape of your mouth, you can control the sound that it makes. So if I wanted to, I could even talk into the Danmoy. For example, I could say the words, "Hello, my name is Andrew." And through the Danmoy, it sounds like this. Pretty cool, huh? This is the Moroccan hockey stick. Now this was based off of an instrument from Africa called a gimri, which is normally made out of camel skins and camel intestines.
I wish to encourage children to think critically, outside the box. How does science relate to the creation of music? Why is it good to look for creative new ways to approach things? Why try to find uses for old toys rather than throwing them away? What can we learn from environmentally respectful practices of other cultures? These are all questions that I would like to raise with children through my musical performance. Thank you for joining me.